Hi guys, how are you all doing today? Welcome to my channel. Have you ever wanted to grow large fruit and vegetables such as tomatoes, bell peppers, cucumbers, squash or eggplants in a hydroponic system but thought it would be too expensive? Then this tutorial on how to build a Dutch bucket system may be your answer. In this video, I'll be showing you how I built this recirculating hydroponic Dutch bucket system. The buckets contain the medium in which the plants grow. Fertilizer solution is delivered through a distribution system made up of a reservoir, pump, drain, and feed lines. The buckets are connected in series and are staggered, with each bucket facing inward, allowing for the use of a single main feed line and drain pipe. The beauty of a Dutch bucket system is that it is scalable. You can build a system using just two buckets or dozens, if not hundreds of buckets. So if you're interested in building this Dutch bucket system, stay tuned. My name is Sharon and I am the Over 60 Crafter. List of materials for a 10 bucket system. 10 food grade buckets. If your buckets are white, you might want to consider painting them to avoid algae. About 15 feet of 2 inch PVC pipe. 8 feet of 1/2 inch PVC pipe. 1 2 inch end cap. 20 1/2 inch PVC 90 degree elbows. 25 feet of 1/4 inch tubing. 16 feet of 1/2 inch poly tubing. 10 3/4 inch grommets. 10 1/4 inch barbed connectors. 10 5-gallon elastic top paint strainer bags. For the stand, I used some concrete blocks and 4 10-foot lengths of 1x3 white pine. Whatever you are using as a stand, remember that it must be higher than the reservoir. I dug a hole 1 foot deep and placed a reservoir in it. This helps keep the water cooler. You would also want to ensure that the end of the drain pipe on the end cap side is at least an inch higher than the end that enters the reservoir, as the reservoir is gravity fed. Tools required for building this system: a drill, a hacksaw. Make sure to use a hole punch for the poly tubing rather than a knife or sharp object, as those may cause leaks. A scissors or utility knife for cutting the tubing, and a tape measure. A 1-inch hole saw. This would also depend on the recommended hole saw for the grommet. For your hydroponic system, you would require the following items: a submersible pump for the reservoir, a pH and ppm meter, an air pump and an air stone, hydroponic fertilizer of your choice, and growing medium such as coccocoir, perlite or hydroton. The 16-pound bag of perlite was able to fill 8 buckets 3/4 full. To determine the amount of 2-inch PVC pipe you would require, measure the distance from your reservoir to where you intend to place the first bucket, then add 11 feet to it. My pipe length was 15 feet. Cut your pipe to length using a hacksaw. Measure off 10 6-inch lengths of the 1-inch PVC, which goes inside the bucket, and 10 pieces at 3 inches in length for outside of the bucket. Cut the pieces using either a hacksaw or a jigsaw. Measure 3 inches from the bottom of your bucket. Drill a pilot hole using the 1-inch hole saw. Then switch the drill to reverse and finish off drilling. Do this for the remaining 9 buckets. Be sure to remove the burrs with a piece of sandpaper. Measure off 10 marks on your 2-inch PVC pipe, placing each a foot apart and starting a foot away from your end cap. Using the 1-inch hole saw on the drill, drill all 10 holes, remembering to drill the pilot hole first, then switch the drill to reverse to finish off the holes. Sand off the flakes as you don't want this stuff getting into your pump. To determine the amount of half-inch tubing you would require, measure from where you intend to place the pump in the reservoir to where you would place your first bucket. Then add 11 feet. Cut your tubing to length using either scissors or utility knife. Measure the distance from your half-inch tubing on your stand to inside the bucket to determine the length of the quarter-inch tubing needed. Cut 10 pieces of the quarter-inch tubing. Then insert the barb connector on one end of each piece. Punch 10 holes in the half-inch poly tubing, each a foot apart, starting a foot away from the end. If there are any guidelines on the tubing, be sure to punch the holes within the lines. Insert the barb connector with a quarter-inch tubing into the half-inch poly tubing. After inserting all 10 barbs, tie off the end by bending the tubing and securing it with a cable tie or two. Your half-inch tubing should now look like this. Grab a bucket and insert the 3/4-inch grommet into the 1-inch hole that you drilled. It might take a bit of an effort. Taper off one of the ends on all of the 6-inch pieces of PVC by either using some sandpaper or rubbing it on a rough surface. Apply a dab of liquid soap to the tapered end of the 6-inch length and insert it into the grommet at a slight angle, then press it in all the way. You may need to hold the back of the grommet from the inside of the bucket to prevent it from popping out. Attach the half-inch PVC elbows on both sides of the 6-inch PVC that was inserted into the grommet. Make sure they are facing down. Attach the 3-inch length to the outside elbow. We are now ready to assemble the system. Rest your 2-inch drain pipe on your stand and insert the end without the end cap into the reservoir. Depending on where your reservoir is located, you may need to add an elbow or two. Ensure that the end with the end cap is slightly higher than the end entering the reservoir. Add the buckets onto your stand by inserting the 1/2-inch PVC into the 1-inch holes. Stagger your buckets one on either side as you go down the length of the pipe. Add your 1/2-inch tubing to the stand and insert the open end into the reservoir. Connect it to your pump and rest it in your reservoir. Fill your reservoir, run your pump, and check your system for leaks. If there are leaks around your barb connectors or grommets, you can apply some aquarium silicone. Be sure to follow the instructions. Once your system is leak-free, you can add your nutrient solution. I am going to prepare a bucket using perlite as a growing medium. Working outdoors, place the paint strainer into the bucket and fill the bucket with the perlite. Avoid breathing in the dust. Hose it down thoroughly until the water runs out through the pipe. Then drain the water and place the bucket in your system. We are now ready to plant our seedlings. Make a hole big enough to accommodate it. Insert the plant and cover it over with the perlite. To avoid algae forming on the top of the perlite, sink a piece of 4-inch PVC near the plant's roots and insert the tubing into it. If your buckets will be placed outdoors, you can cut a hole in the lid and plant the seedling from the top. There you have it, a completed Dutch bucket system. I ran out of perlite for the last two buckets, and to cap off the 2/4-inch feeding tubes, I used 1/4-inch drip emitter plugs, which came with the hole punch. Well, thanks for watching. If you're interested in building an NFT system for leafy greens or learning how to mix your own hydroponic nutrients, be sure to check out my other videos. Happy growing and take care. Bye.